The Emperor's New Clothes. Once upon a time, there lived a rather vain emperor whose only care in life was to dress in fancy clothes. In fact, it was difficult for him to think about anything other than what to wear the next day. Word of the emperor's habits soon spread throughout the land. As the news traveled, two schemers who had heard of the emperor's desires for the latest clothing fashions decided to take advantage of the situation. They introduced themselves at the gate of the palace. "We are two very good tailors. We have invented an extraordinary method to weave a cloth so light and so fine that it looks invisible. As a matter of fact, it is invisible to anyone too stupid to appreciate its quality." The chief of the guards heard the strange story and ran to the emperor and disclosed the incredible news. The emperor's curiosity got the better of him, and he decided to see the two men. "Besides being so light and so fine, Your Highness, this cloth will be woven into colors and designs created especially for you." The emperor gave the two men a large bag of gold coins in exchange for the promise to begin working on fabric immediately. The two scoundrels asked for a loom, silk, and gold thread. Then they pretended to begin working. The emperor thought he had spent his money quite well. In addition to getting a new, extraordinary suit, he would discover which of his subjects were ignorant and incompetent. He had called in an old and wise prime minister, who was considered by everyone to be a man with common sense. "Go and see how the work is proceeding," the emperor told him, "and come back to let me know." The two scoundrels welcomed the prime minister. "We're almost finished, but we need a lot more gold thread. Here, Excellency, admire the colors and feel the softness." The old man tried to see the fabric that was not there. "I can't see anything," he thought. "If I see nothing, the emperor will think that I am incompetent." "What a marvelous fabric," he said. "I will certainly tell the emperor." So the two scoundrels rubbed their hands gleefully. Finally, the emperor received the announcement that the two tailors had come to take all the measurements needed to make the new suit. "Come in," the emperor ordered. The two scoundrels pretended to be holding an enormous bolt of fabric. "Here it is, Your Highness, the result of our labor," the scoundrel said. "At last, the most beautiful fabric in the world is ready for you. Look at the colors, and feel how fine it is." Of course, the emperor did not see any colors and could not feel any cloth between his fingers. He panicked. He felt like fainting. But luckily, the throne was right behind him, so he sat down. But when he realized that no one would know that he did not see the fabric, he felt better. Nobody would find out he was stupid and incompetent. The scheme continued just as the two scoundrels had hoped. The two began cutting the air with scissors while sewing with their needles an invisible cloth. "Your Highness, you'll have to take off your clothes to try on your new ones." The two scoundrels draped the new cloths over him and they held up a mirror. The emperor was embarrassed, but since none of the bystanders seemed to notice that he had nothing on, he felt relieved. "Yes, this is a beautiful suit, and it looks very good on me," the emperor said. "You have done a fine job." "Your Majesty," the prime minister said, "we have a request for you. The people are anxious to see you in your new suit." The emperor was doubtful about showing himself naked to the people, but then he abandoned his fears. After all, only the ignorant and the incompetent wouldn't be able to see his new suit. "All right," he said, "I will grant the people the delight of seeing my new clothes." All the people had gathered in the main square, pushing and shoving to get a better look. Applause welcomed the regal parade. Everyone wanted to see how stupid or incompetent his or her neighbor was. But as the emperor passed, strange murmurs rose from the crowd that were loud enough for everyone to hear. "Look at the emperor's new clothes! They're beautiful! And look at the magnificent colors!" The people all tried to conceal their disappointment at not being able to see the clothes. But since no one was willing to admit his or her own stupidity, they all behaved as the two scoundrels had predicted. A child, however, who could only see things as his eyes showed them to him, went up to the carriage. "The emperor is naked," he said.
"Fool," his father said, "don't talk nonsense."
But the boy's remark, which had been heard by the others, was repeated over and over until everyone cried, "The boy is right! The emperor is naked! It's true!" The emperor realized that the people were right, but he certainly could not admit it. He thought it wiser to continue the procession under the illusion that anyone who couldn't see his clothes was either stupid or incompetent. And he stood on his carriage, while behind him a page held his imaginary royal cloak.